The 2021 Ford Bronco Sport is more than capable off-road. We know that. But what happens when you stable your Bronco in the city? How does it fare then? I spent a few days with the 2021 Bronco Sport Badlands model, the most off-road oriented version of the Bronco Sport, pretending it was my daily driver. And also pretending that I still had places to drive daily, just to see how it performed. In Badlands, guys, the Bronco Sport is powered by a turbocharged 2-liter 4-cylinder engine that makes 250 horsepower and 277 pounds-feet of torque. It's really quite quick for a compact SUV. Managing editor Joe Bruzek used the terms riot and hot rod to describe it, with brisk acceleration from a stop and the kind of responsiveness that can help you safely find a gap to switch lanes in busy traffic. From our collective experience with the base engine, a turbocharged 1.5-liter 3-cylinder, the Bronco Sport Badlands is perhaps overpowered, but it is nice to have that extra oomph when you need it. Having driven a number of pickup trucks in Chicago parking garages, it's clear pretty much any vehicle can fit on city streets. Where the Bronco shines in the city is its roughly escape-sized footprint that makes finding parking, parallel or otherwise, fairly easy. That small footprint doesn't translate into a cramped feel inside either. Rear legroom is lacking, but the cabin as a whole feels very airy and roomy thanks to its excellent visibility, tall roof, and touches like a very low center tunnel and rotary gear selector that make the front seats feel closer to a bench seat than divided buckets. While driving on certain streets in Chicago can feel like going over some whoops in the Baja, Chicago streets are mostly, allegedly, paved. Still, the Bronco Sport Badlands and its beefier suspension, off-road tires, and extra inch of lift compared to most Bronco Sport models proved handy. Even if bumps and potholes don't upset the Bronco Sport Badlands, inside, occupants may be left out to dry. Riding over sections of broken pavement left me bouncing around like I was driving a body-on-frame pickup truck. There are certainly times when I enjoy a bouncy ride, but going from stoplight to stoplight like that is tiring. An off-road feature that did come in handy was the forward camera washer, particularly once the weather turned bad. When road grime made it difficult to see the image from the forward-facing camera, a quick rinse cleared it right up. Throughout my time in the Bronco Sport, the in-car fuel economy gauge showed readings in the range of 15 to 16 miles per gallon. That's not great for a city vehicle, and well below the 2 liters EPA estimated 21 miles per gallon city rating. Now, this wasn't a measured test by any means. There was a lot of idling, including with the windows rolled down in cold weather, and I used the sport driving mode a fair amount. But even if the Bronco Sport had hit its EPA estimate, 21 miles per gallon is still well below the 25 to 27 miles per gallon estimates for high-level all-wheel drive trims of popular compact SUVs like the Honda CR-V, Nissan Rogue, and Toyota RAV4. The Badlands' off-road abilities and more powerful engine come with a cost. For all its roominess, the Bronco Sport's interior didn't really impress me. The Badlands' specific use of rubber for the cargo area, including the backs of the rear seats, is useful and a great idea, but other materials and design choices had me debating whether they were really for a utilitarian, easy-to-clean look or cost savings. One area that definitely felt like the latter was the central touchscreen, which is small and uses Ford's older Sync 3 operating system instead of the new Sync 4. That means there's no wireless Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, just the wired versions. There's ample storage in the Bronco Sport, which is nice. Areas like the shelf below the touchscreen can fit a large phone, as long as it's not plugged into a USB cord. The end of my phone stuck out from the opening and seemed likely to fall if I hit some bumpy patches. I left it in the lower storage area or a cup holder rather than risk it. The Bronco Sport does have a few interior tricks of varying levels of utility. The storage compartment under the right rear passenger seat is a nice touch, as are the movable lights in the liftgate that can be positioned to illuminate the area underneath once the liftgate is raised. The bottle opener mounted in the cargo area frame feels a bit silly, but hey, why not? Overall, the Bronco Sport Badlands handles the city moderately well. We've already established that pretty much any vehicle can be a city car if you really want it to be, and are willing to live with inconveniences. And the Bronco Sport certainly has a few. When we get our hands on a less off-road oriented Bronco Sport, we'll have to see if the smaller engine and more street-oriented tires and suspension perform more favorably on pavement. For now, however, we know the Bronco Sport Badlands is a Bronco that needs to be able to run free. As a purely city car, the Bronco Sport Badlands probably isn't the best choice. But if you want a small car for both off and on-road driving, and with a few tricks up its sleeve, the Bronco Sport is tough to beat. Oh,